Truth is,
most people think the flu isn't a big deal.
Every year, 5 to 20% of those living in the United States will become infected with the flu.
Truth is, I never thought it could happen to me.
Our son Alex was like any other teenage boy. Loved school, sports, friends, and video games. Just a regular kid. All that changed in October of 2009. Alex woke up and had flu-like symptoms, had a fever, achy, was not feeling good, and it wasn't a normal flu. It didn't seem like a normal, like he just wasn't right. And the next day, October 13th, I called his pediatrician and took him in, and he was diagnosed with the influenza A, which was H1N1.
From April 2009 to May 2010, over 100 flu-related deaths were reported in Illinois, 3 in McLean County.
They admitted him into the Children's Hospital of Illinois that Sunday. They've tried everything to get him better with antibiotics. He just did not have any energy, could not even get out of bed, just laid there for a week. Finally, on October 26th, around 2 in the morning, they decided to move him up to the ICU and intubate him. When this happened to Alex, this changed how we thought about flu prevention and getting the flu shot. I never thought that a flu would do that to anybody. In fact, I thought everybody was being silly, how worried they were about it, and how everybody was canceling different events, and companies were canceling their business trips because of the H1N1, and I actually thought that was very silly, and now I don't. Alex was put into an induced coma on October 26th. He was in the pediatric ICU for 3 weeks. It was very hard to see. I'd say the first week was probably the hardest. He was constantly getting medicine for, you know, his blood pressure going higher or low blood pressure, his fevers. He was spiking fevers. I think his fever broke after actually 2 weeks, and he was more alert. He does not remember, but he did communicate with us a little bit with nodding his head and opening his eyes. After 3 weeks of being on the ventilator, they extubated him, and it was a Saturday afternoon. He did great when he got off of that. He still was on the oxygen, and he ended up staying in ICU for 2 more days and then moved to intermediate care. He was in intermediate care for a week, and they did physical and occupational therapy with him, and for him to get out of bed and just walk to the door was great, but he was out of breath. I mean, it was very hard for him. He was about 5'6 and down to 84 pounds. We took him home the day before Thanksgiving, being able to be home as a family and not have mom or dad gone and just have, you know, that was kind of hard. And I think that was hard for the kids, having one of us gone at all times. And 2 years later, Alex is happy, healthy, doing everything a kid should do, playing sports, playing with his friends, active. We heard all the stories on the news about H1N1, but we never thought a thing about it. Since Alex's illness, we're an advocate of the flu shot, and we've gotten one ever since.
Getting a flu shot is the number one way to prevent the flu.
Truth is,
the flu can happen to anyone,
anywhere.